Hello there. Welcome to the Word Power Encounter, a place where you encounter God through these times of fellowship. My name is Reverend Captain Martin Bandu, Senior Pastor, Sitam Kikuyu Town Church, a place where in the center of Kikuyu Town, where people encounter God and also Christ is the answer.
Praise the Lord and welcome to Word Power Encounter. My name is Elaine Masharia and I'm coming to you from Sitam Kikuyu Town Church, from the heart of Kikuyu, where Christ is the answer. And as we come to conclude this series on our confidence in God, I remember I began by asking, where is your confidence in this season? And the beginning of Lamentations chapter 3 verse 21 says that, yet I call this to mind and therefore I have hope. And I want to skip to verse 24 that says that the Lord is my portion. I will say to myself, the Lord is my portion, therefore I will wait upon him. So what we're trying to say by all of this is that in the midst of everything that Jeremiah and the rest of the Judeans were going through in the time of crisis, in the times of calamity, he stopped to think. And what did he think about? He thought about the love of God. He thought about the mercy of God. He thought about the faithfulness of God. And therefore, the result was that it gave him hope. Now, when I think about the language about love, about grace, about mercy, and about faithfulness, it is how God communicates to us concerning our relationship towards us and towards him. And so even in our season and in our time, the Lord is just reminding us that when Jeremiah wrote and said that the Lord is my portion, he was saying that I have seen and I have known this God who is loving, who is merciful, who is faithful, that he is my God. It was a confession. It was a declaration. It was a shout of victory, declaring that I know that this God, who is all of these things, he is my God and I am his people. It's the same way in the book of Psalms. The psalmist writes and says that we are the sheep of his pasture, that we are his flock and he is our God. It is in the very same way in the book of Galatians chapter 4 verse 6 and in Romans chapter 8 verse 15. It says that we are the children of God because we have the Spirit of God. And it says because we have received the Spirit of sonship, it cries out, Abba, Father. And so in this season and in this time, by virtue of being a child of God, there is an appeal that we continue to lift up to God, to our Father, Abba Father, and we keep calling unto him. And that is the assurance that we have, that he is our God and we are his people. It is the language of covenant. It is the language of love, that he is ours and we are his. And when he's saying that the Lord is my portion, it's in the same way that the Lord spoke to Abraham in the book of Genesis chapter 15 verse 1. And he says that the Lord is your shield and he's your exceedingly great reward. And I want to encourage you and tell you that even as we come to the close of this series, that the Lord is our reward. When I say that he is our portion, it means that he is mine and I belong to him. It means that when other people are looking for other things to satisfy, I say that the Lord is my portion. I say that when the world is looking to technology, my response is that the Lord is my portion. That when the world is looking to devices, when the world is looking to itself, to humanity, exalting self above God, my declaration and our declaration as those who belong to God is that he is ours and we are his, that the Lord is my portion. And I want to add something, that the book of Lamentations, this last verse speaks and says, he says that, therefore I tell myself, and I want you to speak to yourself and say, that the Lord is my portion. And so we position ourselves in the knowledge of who we are in God. Our identity is with Christ. Our security is in Christ and who he is. And that means that because he is that, because he is our security and our portion, we find rest in him. And so what is the response once we know who God is? That this is what the writer speaks and says. He says that, therefore, I will wait for him. I will wait for him. May there be a stillness in our hearts as we position ourselves as waiting on God. As Isaiah chapter 40 verse 30 to 31 says, that those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Let it be that our position is waiting upon God. Confidence in Him is waiting upon Him. So where is my confidence? My response is, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, we wait upon Him. And so, Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank You that You are our portion. We thank You that You are our God. We thank You that, Lord, we are hidden with Christ in God. We thank You that we are eternally secure in You. We thank You that, Lord, You are at work in every situation and circumstance. And so ours is our declaration that my confidence is in the Lord. That in this season and in this time, Father, we declare that our confidence is in You, because You are consistent, You are reliable, and You will not change. And so because You will not change, I thank You that, Lord, Your people are receiving rest today in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank You. I thank You that, Lord, You are silencing fears. You are silencing anxieties. You are answering questions and doubts with the revelation of who You are. I pray the prayer that Paul prayed over the Ephesian church, that they may receive the spirit of wisdom and revelation, and that they may be able to know You better. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and believe. Amen. God bless you, and may God continue to reveal Himself in this season and in this time as an ever-present help. God bless you.
We thank you for tuning in, listening in, and even watching. May God bless you as you grow in the Lord. And thank you for watching this program.